Hey, I'm putting this a shout out there to the Edgeverse and my friends, where we share sort of ideas going back and forth. And I'm call this poking the online hornet's nest. You know, I talk to lots of kids every year about things they do online and making good decisions. And this idea of poking the online hornet's nest is what. So to illustrate this story, I'll take you to a real hornet's nest story. When I was in eighth grade, we lived in New Oxford, Pennsylvania. My father, you know, by the afternoon, 5 o'clock to midnight, you know, was his prime being drunk time. So usually by the time we got home from school, he was well on his way to having, you know, a good buzz going. So there came a day when one of us kids discovered a hornet's nest in a tree in front of our house. A big old hornet's nest, bigger than a football, you know, one of those kinds of hornet's nests. And so we told my dad about it. And my dad usually had a studied approach to these perceived problems. And the perceived problem was that there were hornets and they were in our yard, you know. And so the perceived solution was shoot it with a shotgun. So his dad made his plan and gathered his shotgun shells and took his 12-gauge out into the yard. The rest of the family, being, I don't know, genetically superior in some way, decided not to be with him when said incident occurred. And this is not the only incident like this where the family abandoned Dad in his hour of need. I always felt like, you know, making a really stupid choice sort of outstripped any loyalty that I might be called upon to have in cases like this. And in other cases, if I have a friend who is getting ready to do a really stupid thing, and if I've warned them, then I don't feel like I need to stand there and get destroyed with them, you know. So anyway, my dad goes out, you know, aims his gun into the air, and we're all inside watching out the window as Dad pulls the trigger and shoots the hornet's nest. And I don't know if Dad thought in his mind, you know, birdshot, how many pellets per cartridge. If one pellet hits each bee, there'll be no leftover angry, dangerous bees to sting me. And that these traumatized bees but in no way could fall straight out of the tree right where I am, you know. So somehow Dad's logic had it figured out that he would kill every bee with one shot. It was a single shot shotgun, and then walk off, you know, in a blaze of glory, hornet's nest being gone, danger being therefore removed from family, which, you know, is in some ways laudable. So Dad pulls the trigger and shoots the hornet's nest, at which time the hornet's nest falls out of the tree and lands right in front of him. It turns out that not all the hornets were killed in the blast. In fact, it seems that very few of them were actually even rendered anything other than extremely hostile by the blast. So Dad immediately erupts into a kind of frenetic dance that we're all kind of enjoying from inside the house. And in typical sort of Honeycutt style, we're all laughing until we can't breathe as Dad doesn't run, really. He sort of dances there in place for a while. And it could be a combination of alcohol, adrenaline, the pain of the stings, you know, bloodborne poisons associated with the stinging mechanism. In any case, Dad stood there for what seemed like an eternity, dancing the hornet, dance while we all were pressed against the glass, just laughing. Then Dad sort of ran toward the house, and then our fear was that they would follow him in, so we all found different rooms to occupy and doors to close. But they didn't really follow him in except those that had adhered to his clothing, which he was rapidly killing. With us muffling the sounds of us continuing to laugh and try to breathe in adjacent rooms. So lesson learned, you know, don't shoot a hornet's nest, but lesson learned for online, don't poke a hornet's nest. You know, or you should know, and maybe we have to teach our friends to know that there are times when you don't go in there and rush in and make, you know, a million people hate you with one statement. Also to think enough to realize not everyone agrees with you. And I think there are times when people say things just thinking for sure that everyone in the world agrees with them. And amazingly surprised, not unlike Dad was surprised, that it turns out a bunch of hostility remained after the initial blast. So lesson in my mind illustrated by Dad's behavior, don't poke the online hornet's nest. Now the real question behind all of this is, how do we teach kids to know what a hornet's nest is online and how to properly or safely either approach them or to learn from them but let them be. So what are the things that we can do to help teach people that? Is it one of our jobs to help teach people that? What are the consequences if we don't? A few questions for my friends online. See ya.